Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a step-by-step acrylic video. A lot of you guys have been asking me to do this, so this is what I'm doing. I'm so excited for this video because I miss doing nails. I really miss doing nails. So we're just going to be getting right into it. These are just all the products that I'm using. I'm just showing you. Normally I use my Melody Susie nail drill, but I like this one too, and I normally keep it at my desk if my Melody Susie is dead. So I do use both of them. So going in, I normally cut my nails down. If they're a little bit longer, then I definitely cut them, but I didn't have no nails. I always keep my nails short. So I'm just showing you that I do cut them for reference. And then right here, I am just pushing back the cuticles. That way I could just prep and make sure there is no dead skin on my nail beds. Now going in with a fine sanding bit and my nail drill, which is from BT Art Box. I'm guessing that's the name. I don't know. I will try to link a drill down below. I definitely love Melody Susie. If you wanted to try them out, you can, because I know I love them. But yeah, so right here I am just drilling my nails, and I'm making sure that I'm not like digging the drill into my nails, so that way I don't cause damage or any fire burns. So you're gonna see here that I'm showing you I am keeping the drill moving from sidewall to sidewall, just so that way it's not sitting still like this. So you don't want it to sit still, you want it to keep going, because if not, you will burn yourself, you will burn your client. Just a nice little reference. So I'm just taking off any dust that is on my nail. And of course, I don't like to prep my nails as much because I do make a lot of videos. So I did put a clear coat on my nails. That's why you may see them a little shiny. But I'm just showing you that you gotta make sure you choose the right nail tip. So this one was the best one. The other one was way too big, so it was falling off sidewall to sidewall, and then this one is way too small. So I'm gonna show you other ones. This one is still big, and then this one is just, it just sits perfect. So you have to make sure about your nail tips. Just showing you different ones. You have to make sure with your nail tips, so that way you don't, because if you put it too big, it'll lift, and if you put it too small, it'll lift. So you have to make sure you get the right size, because that can cause problems also. So yeah, these nail tips are from Ejubis, I think that's the name of it, and I'm just using regular nail glue. They do come shaped as coffins, so I ended up keeping the shape because I actually love it. It's like a coffin square type, but more on the coffin side. So I do love that. And they are clear. So yeah, you can shape them any kind of shape that you want. I will link it, I will leave a link down below in the description box for you guys. I did do a video of how I shape my nails in different shapes, but right here I am just cutting the tip off so I don't have to file, because your girl doesn't like to file. So, and I'm lazy, so we're just gonna cut the tip off. You can just file if you want that extra length, but I literally took nothing off but the number. So yeah, that's good to go. And then you can file the nail tip, which I'm gonna show you that right here. You can, but I normally don't. I feel like it's no use. So yeah, right here I'm just applying some primer, and with my brush I'm just dipping it in, taking out all the bubbles and making sure my brush is good to go. Now my acrylic was acting weird this day, like it was just drying super fast. Glitter bells does tend to do that, so it does tend to dry fast when I'm using like an easy flow product with it. I'm pretty sure like maybe if they have their own monomer it works good, but some of them, easy flow, the monomer that I am using, it is a fast drying monomer, so maybe that's why. But still, your girl was stressed out, like why was it drying so fast? But as you guys can see, I'm just cleaning up from sidewall to sidewall. I'm using my Panna brush, and I know a lot of you guys are gonna ask me, do I put a clear base? I do not. I don't believe in putting a clear base if it's a cover. Now if it's just a regular color, then I will not, but this is a cover pink, so it shouldn't lift. It doesn't have as much coloring as a normal color would have, or a lot of, you know, things like that to make it lift. So yeah, normally if I do get lifting, then I will not support that brand with the covers. I just feel like if I use Mia Secret, and it's a very cheap brand that you can get for super cheap and save your coins, If I feel like being a secret, you don't have to put a clear down, then I feel like anybody that makes covers, you shouldn't have to put a clear down. And I haven't noticed that with Glitter Bells, so it's definitely not a problem with them. I know I could be a little harsh in the nail industry, like with, you know, some of the products, but there's so many cheap products that work amazing that big brands put down. And I just feel like, no, I just feel like that's a no-no. But I do love Glitter Bells. Their glitters and their acrylics are really, really nice to work with. It was just drying super fast for some reason, which was weird. Other than that, I do use them a lot in my videos. And yeah, so that's all that I'm doing. I'm just putting it halfway because I am going to be doing a ombre, and I'm also going to be using their glitter acrylics. Normally, if I'm missing like patches here and there, then I'll add just a little bit of acrylic here and there. You can do one ball methods, but your girl, listen, I'm still learning myself. I'm not a huge fan of one ball methods. I like taking my time and having it come out right the first time than having to struggle the second time with a one ball method. And I'm not perfect at one ball methods, so I'm not even gonna break my head over it. But yeah, so that's what I'm just doing right here. And then when I get into the glitters, it gets a little bit easier. Now I do just stay cleaning sidewall to sidewall just so that way I don't lose that coffin shape. So when I go to file, it's just super easy for me. I just file a little bit and then I'm out the door and ready to go. So right here, you'll see me putting the glitters down, and I don't put too much, just one ball, and I drag it up, drag it down. I put a little bit more if I have to, the glitters, to smear it everywhere so it can look like an ombre. And I don't put anything on top. You can, I know there's a design where you can put like your cover over it, but I didn't want to do that today. And then I'm just gonna encapsulate with clear, which the clear that I'm using is from Mia's Secret. And I'm sorry if I'm talking too much, but a lot of you guys wanted me to do a step-by-step, and this is a step-by-step me talking through the whole video. And yeah, like I was saying, you guys wanted me to do an ombre, so I decided to do this one. And the clear that I'm using is from Easy Flow. A lot of you guys have asked me if it works really good. I love this acrylic. Hands down, the best acrylic I can ever find for an affordable price. Beginner friendly, definitely. Anytime, any day. Mia's Secret, definitely the best brand you can have and work with. It dries at a calmly matter, like it's just amazing. And way affordable than a lot of brands out here. So definitely recommend those two brands. Easy Flow and Mia's Secret are top 10 on my list, top 20 on my list. And I've been using them since I started my career, and I will continue to use them until I finish my career. Like, that's just how I feel about them. Unless they do some crazy stuff and then I gotta change it, but I hope they don't do nothing crazy. So yeah, I really, really, really love Easy Flow and Mia's Secret. Definitely recommend them. I know a lot of you guys have asked me, do I recommend them? 100% recommend Mia's Secret and Easy Flow. They're definitely the best brands that you can get out there. Now, as far as my brush, a lot of you guys have asked me for my brush. I won't be linking these products in the description box because I am talking about them now. As for my brush, it is from eBay. So I just type in Pana brush, P-A-N-A brush, nail brush, and it comes up. It has different sizes. You can get the purple one or the blue one. They both work perfect. I have both of them, and I do gravitate towards my purple one more because I've had it for almost 2 years. But I do love the blue one also. And yeah, so for the clear, I don't put it on the cuticle because the cuticle is already thick. I just put it like midway to the cuticle and then going down to the free edge. So I just wanted to throw that out there because a lot of you guys were like, well, do you cover the whole nail with clear? No, just where I see the glitter and where it starts. So if it starts halfway, if it starts to the cuticle, that means that I just did the whole nail as a glitter nail. And yes, I would encapsulate the whole nail, but if I did an ombre, then I would just encapsulate halfway, if that makes sense. I hope that made sense to you guys, because I try to make it make sense, but I know it's weird to hear it and then actually see it. So that's why I try not to talk too much through the video, so you guys can actually pay attention. I feel like when I talk, you guys lose a little bit of your concentration, if that makes sense. I know I do sometimes watching people. So so that's another thing. And the monomer that I'm using also is from Easy Flow. So these two products are from Easy Flow. And I just have a big container of the Easy Flow powder because I buy them in bulk. And I just put them in this little container that I got. It is like a competitor's white from Easy Flow, but yeah, I know what I'm getting at. So right here, I am just going to be filing. And what I'm showing you is that I do love my nails curved, but I also like my nails to be straight. And what I mean by straight is the reason why I'm filing underneath like I was just a minute ago. I'll show you again in the other part. And then I'm just filing sidewall to sidewall and then the free edge to get my shape. So as you guys can see, I am filing like this, that right there. And I'm doing that so my nail can be straight. You can have them curved, but I like them straight like this and then have my apex curve with thickness. If that makes sense also. I feel like that didn't make sense. So I'm just, like I said, I'm just filing from sidewall to sidewall. And once I get done filing, I just go in with my nail drill. Now that's a whole different video that I want to make. I want to show you guys how to use the nail drill, but everybody uses it different. Everybody has their own opinions. Everybody has like this, it has to be a certain way, this and that. But everybody literally uses their nail drill completely different. Some people hold it weird. Some people hold the finger weird that they're working with. Some people hold their hand weird when they're doing it. So it's just like, it's just your own preference. And I kind of feel like that's like a touchy subject when I go to talk about it or when I go to actually put that video up. I feel like people are going to either like it, hate it, or love it. Like, it's not like an in-between with people. And I understand because everybody has their different opinions. So if you definitely want to see that video, I can definitely get that out for you guys. But it's just like I just have to get ready for the comments, because I know everybody has their own opinions. And I do use my drill completely different from somebody else, and I know they use their drill completely different from how I use it. I don't apply too much pressure when I'm using the drill, so yes, my nails stay a little bit thick. I love my nails thick. If my client doesn't, then of course I will thin them down, or I'll try to put the acrylic on thinner because I already know how my client likes it. No, I do not have clients anymore because I don't do clients anymore. But like my family and stuff like that and friends that I do, yes, I do what they like. But at the end of the day, like I said, you know, my nails, I like them thick. Not everybody likes them thick. So just wanted to put that out there. I will make the video for you guys if that's what you want to see. But everybody just has their different opinions about the drill. Like, you're gonna see when I go to do the drill that I don't put too much pressure and I just file it real quick, 1, 2, 3. So people are gonna say, oh, that wasn't, you didn't do enough. And that's fine. I may not have done enough for them, but for me, I have. So I'm just cleaning up my cuticle and I'm dragging down the nail bit, which I'm using a fine drill bit. And I'm just dragging it down, and that's about it. And I'm also going to be filing underneath so that way it doesn't stay bulky and look weird. So as you guys can see, I got a nice apex. It's nice, it's thin at the bottom, thin at the top, but in the middle it's nice and thick, and that's how I like it. But yeah, other than that, this is kind of all that I did. Super easy, super quick. You can literally do this at home if you have all the stuff. I maybe used about 10 products, and not even. You literally don't need a whole bunch of stuff, you guys. You need the minimal. Don't sit here and buy a whole nail kit of $500 for $20 nails, to be completely honest. Most of the time when you're going to go to the nail salon, you're paying for labor, not the stuff that they're buying. So let's just put that out there. So yeah, I just, after this, I'm just going to be buffing it, and I'm going to be applying some cuticle oil, washing my hands, applying top coat, and applying some more cuticle oil, and I'm good to go. I'm done. If you like these step-by-step videos and you like me talking in your ear constantly, definitely let me know with a big thumbs up. and comment down below that you enjoyed this video, please, because I would love your feedback. And not only that, subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you can be notified each time that I upload, because I would really, really like that. And not only that, follow me on Instagram because I do giveaways and a whole bunch of good stuff, and I post on there, and I post a little bit of my regular personal life and things like that. So if you want to check that out, definitely follow me on my Instagram and check out the giveaways that I have on this channel going on, because it's amazing giveaways. So other than that, I hope you guys had a good one. I hope you guys had fun watching me do these nails, and I will see you in my next video.